Let us pray. In the name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Go before us, O Lord, and further us with your continual help, that in all our works begun, continued, and ended in you, we may glorify your holy name, and find by mercy obtain everlasting life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. O God the Father, Creator of heaven and earth. O God the Son, Redeemer of the world. O God the Holy Spirit, Advocate and Guide. O Holy, Blessed and Glorious Trinity, three persons in one God. Lord, remember not our offenses, nor the offenses of our forebears. Spare us, good Lord. Spare your people whom you have redeemed with your precious blood.
Spare us, good Lord.
From all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the cunning assaults of the devil, from your wrath, and from everlasting condemnation.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From all spiritual blindness, from pride, vanity and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, malice, and all uncharitableness.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From fornication, adultery, and all other disordered and sinful affections, from the deceits of the world and the snares of the devil.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart, and from contempt of your word and commandment.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From lightning, fire, and hurricane, from earthquake, drought, and flood, from famine, plague, COVID-19, and pestilence.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion, from violence, battle, and murder, and from dying suddenly and unprepared.
Good Lord, deliver us.
By the mystery of your holy incarnation, by your birth, childhood, and obedience, by your baptism, fasting, and temptation.
Good Lord, deliver us.
By your ministry in word and work, by your mighty acts of power, by your proclamation of the kingdom.
Good Lord, deliver us.
By your agony and sweat of blood, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial. By your mighty resurrection, by your glorious ascension, and by the coming of the Holy Spirit. In all times of trial and sorrow, in all times of joy and prosperity, in the hour of death, and at the day of judgment, hear our prayers, O Lord our God. Govern and direct your holy church, fill it with love and truth, and grant it that unity which is your will.
Hear us, good Lord.
Give us boldness to preach the gospel in all the world, and to make disciples of all nations.
Hear us, good Lord.
Enlighten all bishops, especially Howard our Archbishop, Leopold our Bishop, Gregory, Bishop of our companion diocese, priests and deacons, with true knowledge and understanding, that by their life and teaching they may proclaim your word.
Yes, good Lord.
Give your people grace to hear and receive your word, to find and follow their true vocation, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit.
Yes, good Lord.
Bring into the way of truth all of erred and are deceived.
Yes, Lord.
Strengthen those who stand, comfort and help the faint-hearted, raise up the fallen, and finally beat down Satan under our feet.
Yes, Lord.
Guide the leaders of the nations into the way of justice and peace.
Yes, Lord.
Enlighten and direct our rulers, especially Neville, our Governor General, Allen, our Prime Minister, Philip, our Leader for Majesty's Opposition, Andy, Speaker of the House of Assembly, Janine, President of the Senate, all members of Parliament, both upper and lower houses, grant that they may put their trust in you and seek only your honor and glory.
Yes.
Grant wisdom and insight to all in authority, especially Sharon, our Chief Medical Officer, and to judges and magistrates, the grace to administer justice with mercy.
Yes.
Give to all nations peace, unity, and concord, and grant to all people freedom and dignity, food and shelter.
Yes.
Teach us to use resources of the earth to your glory, that all may share in your goodness and praise you for your loving kindness.
Yes.
Enlighten with your spirit all who teach and all who learn.
Yes.
Help and comfort the lonely and aged, the bereaved, the overworked, the exploited, and the oppressed.
Yes, Lord.
Support and encourage all who are in poverty, unemployment, or distress. Protect those whose work is dangerous, and keep in safety all who travel.
Yes, Lord.
Keep fathers, mothers, and children united in their family life, and give them wisdom and strength in times of stress.
Yes, Lord.
Heal the sick in mind and body. Strengthen and preserve all women in childbirth and all young children.
Yes, Lord.
Defend and provide for the widowed and the orphaned, all migrant workers and refugees, the homeless and victims of strife. Have pity on prisoners and all who live in fear.
Yes, Lord.
Forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and turn their hearts.
Yes, Lord.
Savior of the world, forgive our sins known and unknown, things done and left undone. Grant us the grace of your Holy Spirit that we may amend our lives according to your holy word.
Holy God, holy and strong, holy and immortal, have mercy upon us.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace to bring before you to one accord our common supplications, and you promise that when two or three are gathered together in your name, you'll be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of your servants, as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the world to come the fullness of eternal life.
Amen.
The introit hymn, number five.
Sleep.
Let me hear of your loving kindness in the morning, for I put my trust in you. Show me the road that I must walk, for I lift up my soul to you. Good morning to everyone.
Good morning.
And welcome to this act of worship for the 15th Sunday after Pentecost, according to Proper 19. This act of worship of morning prayer and Holy Eucharist in one kind with hymns continues on page 35 of the liturgy book. Please turn to page 35. Blessed be the Lord our God. Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ. Blessed be the Spirit of God,
in whom is our hope and our joy.
Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. The Canticle, Christ our Passover. Together, Christ our Passover has been sacrificed for us. So let us celebrate the feast, not with the old leaven of corruption and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Christ, once raised from the dead, dies no more. Death has no more dominion over him. In dying, he died to sin once for all. In living, he lives to God. See yourselves, therefore, as dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who sleep. For as by man came death, by man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. In a moment of silence, we examine ourselves before Almighty God. General Confession. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen in all goodness, and keep in life eternal through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the reading of the appointed Psalm. Psalm 114, 114. This begins on page 621 of the liturgy book. The reading of Psalm 114, beginning at the first verse. Hallelujah! When Israel came out of Egypt, the house of Jacob from a people of strange speech. The sea beheld it and fled. Jordan turned and went back.
Mountains skipped like rams, and little hills like young sheep.
What ail you, O sea, that you fled? O Jordan, that you turn back?
Mountains that skipped like rams, little hills like young sheep.
Tremble, O earth, at the presence of the Lord, at the presence of the God of Jacob.
Who turned the narrow into a pool of water, and has stolen into a flowing spring.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus, chapter 14, verses 19 to 31. Exodus, chapter 14, verses 19 to 31. The angel of God, who was going before the Israelite army, moved and went behind them, and the pillar of cloud moved from in front of them and took its place behind them. It came between the army of Egypt and the army of Israel. And so the cloud was there with the darkness, and it lit up the night. One did not come near the other all night. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. The Lord drove the sea back by a strong east wind all night and turned the sea into dry land, and the waters were divided. The Israelites went into the sea on dry ground, and the waters forming a wall for them on their right and on their left. The Egyptians pursued and went into the sea after them, all of Pharaoh's horses, chariots, and chariot drivers. At the morning watch, the Lord in the pillar of fire and cloud looked down upon the Egyptian army and threw the Egyptian army into panic. He clogged their chariot wheels so that they turned with difficulty. The Egyptians said, "Let us flee from the Israelites, for the Lord is fighting for them against Egypt." Then the Lord said to Moses, stretch out your hand over the sea, so that the water may come back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and chariot drivers. So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn the sea returned to its normal depth. As the Egyptians fled before it, the Lord tossed the Egyptians into the sea. The waters returned and covered the chariots and the chariot drivers, the entire army of Pharaoh that had followed them into the sea. Not one of them remained. But the Israelites walked on dry ground through the sea, the waters forming a wall for them on their right and on their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel that day from the Egyptians, and Israel saw the Egyptians dead on the seashore. Israel saw the great work that the Lord did against the Egyptians. So the people feared the Lord and believed in the Lord and in his servant Moses. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The office hymn 524, 524. on page 40, the Benedictus. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You have raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of your servant David. Through your holy prophets, you promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our forebears, to Abraham's holy covenant. This was the oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare the way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins, in the tender compassion of our God. The dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine upon those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Please be seated for the reading of the second lesson.
The second lesson is taken from Romans chapter 14, verses 1 to 12. Welcome those who are weak in faith, but not for the purpose of quarreling over opinions. Some believe in eating anything, while the weak eat only vegetables. Those who eat must not despise those who abstain, and those who abstain must not pass judgment on those who eat, for God has welcomed them. Who are you to pass judgment on servants of another? It is before their own Lord that they stand or fall, and they will be upheld. For the Lord is able to make them stand. Some judge one day to be better than another, while others judge all days to be alike. Let all be fully convinced in their own minds. Those who observe the day observe in the honor of the Lord. Also those who eat, eat in the honor of the Lord, since they give thanks to God, while those who abstain, abstain in the honor of the Lord and give thanks to God. We do not live to ourselves, and we do not die to ourselves. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, so that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why do you pass judgment on your brothers or sisters? Or you? Why do you despise your brother or sister? For we all stand before the judgment seat of God. For it is written, "As I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall give praise to God." So then, each of us will be accountable to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
On page 56, we stand for the canticle, God's Plan of Salvation. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with all the spiritual blessings of heaven. God chose us in Christ before the world was made to be holy and blameless, and to live by his love in his presence. God planned through Jesus Christ to bring us to himself as his children, that we might praise the glory of his grace, his free gift to us in the beloved. In Christ we gain redemption. Through his blood our sins are forgiven. How rich is the grace of God! I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. On page 44, suffrages B. Show us your mercy, O Lord.
Grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only you can live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
O God, because without you we are not able to please you, mercifully grant that your Holy Spirit may in all things direct and rule our hearts. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Lord God, almighty, everlasting Father, you have brought us in your safety to this new day. Preserve us with your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin, nor be overcome by adversity, and in all we do, direct us to the fulfilling of your purpose, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
In our prayers, let us remember to pray for all of our actual prayers and the prayers of the church. Let us remember to pray for all those we've been praying for and the various things we are asking God for. Lord, in your mercy, we sum up our prayers in the words of the prayer of dedication as found on page 47 of the liturgy book. Let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. May divine assistance remain with us all. May the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace and arise in glory. Amen. If you have not yet placed your offering in the offering basket, now is a good time to do so. I leave with you words from the second scripture reading this morning, taken from Romans chapter 14 and part of verse 8 and 9, as food for thought today and during this ensuing week, especially as we consider the question, how am I responding to God's call on my life? How am I responding to God's call on my life? Paul, speaking to the young church at Rome, makes the point, we do not live unto ourselves. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We do not live unto ourselves. Ponder this today and the rest of this week. We stand as I invite us to bring all our cares, all our concerns to Almighty God, and of course our offering in the offertory hymn 215, 215. And on page 144, as our Savior has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Amen.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. The gifts of God for the people of God.
Our souls in peace and satisfy, and we will sing that song of praise to Him.
Body of Christ. 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 Eternal God and Heavenly Father, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you and all persons in you with gladness and singleness of heart through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you, remain with you, now and forevermore.
Amen.
Recessional hymn 471. To love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ, amen.
To have a blessed day and week, everyone. Thank you very much.
Go now in
we express our gratitude once more to the several middle houses for carrying this act of worship on this Sunday morning. Thank you very much. May God bless you.